Good morning, Deify here, and welcome back to Kitty Powers Matchmaker, our quest for all the achievements. And hold on, I got this. 13 more babies, and that's it. We got our Steam friends. Yes, I'm so happy. And now we just need to continue trudging forward with trying to get couples to procreate with each other. And Olivia doesn't look like she's going to be one of them. Now, had to finish with Patrick because he was just totally wrong for me. There were some things I liked about him, mainly his interest in tennis, but I just couldn't stand his bizarre compulsion for school satchels. Patrick wasn't for me, but at least I was honest about it. Patrick bombarded me with texts and emails for weeks afterwards. I had to get an injunction against him and change all the locks. Why'd you have to change all the locks? That's a... You guys never moved into... I don't know. Maybe you did. Lydia and I are still together, and we have a place of our own. We both really enjoy playing table tennis. We're so compatible that I can easily live with their obsession with ethnic music. Did tell one or two white lies, but it was okay in the end. We're really happy together. This could be for life. We sent you a little something to say thanks. From Charlie and Lydia. Yeah, I wasn't expecting these two to do super duper well. Oh, more stags for men. I got that last time, though. Well, I guess we'll just go in order now, because I don't even need to try and find someone who's looking for a woman, since I have now set up all my Steam friends. We're just going to start with Pauline Buttercastle, the VIP philanthropist and a Gemini, born on May 23rd, and looking for anything. Her interests include decorating cakes, archaeology, and herb lore. She loves blue eyes and black hair. She's active, carefree, introvert, traditional, and romantic. Her bad habit is sleeping all day, and her guilty pleasure is tomb raiding. Let's see what we have for this vintage type who also is... I don't know, geeky? Where does tomb raiding fall in? I can only think of Lara Croft. Interdasting. Very interdasting. Milan Vinenell seems like a fine match that I'm kind of curious about. And I'm just going to set him up and you'll see why. He's a 2-star medium and a Capricorn. They'll have 2 ticks of attraction once we give her light brown hair. But 5 out of 5 is really the selling point, even though we don't know his bad habit and guilty pleasure. So I have kind of had a doozy of a day. My friends and I went downtown. We went back to the thrift stores and I got some kind of cool stuff. I got like a new dress shirt and a new t-shirt and a CD of a band that I've been kind of trying to get into, but hey, it was like $3. Now I can get into them. I want something hot with no meat. I can find that for you. Like Zagaloo. Yeah, there we go. From our super ponytail mustache soul patch man. And that was all fine and dandy, except like I've been in so much pain today. Like, I must have slept badly, but I have a pinched nerve in my back that I can't get out. My shoes, as I believe I said in the last episode, are giving out, so my heel is, like, super bruised, and it's not feeling good. I should probably try and, get a new pair of shoes, but I'm kind of low on funds because I'm a college student. I used to have this maths teacher who actually turned out to be Air Bud. There are no rules against a dog teaching math. when I was a child, we used to go sailing for our holes. Our holes? I don't know. When I was young, I had a pet kitty cat, and I trained it to do tricks and everything. It was marvelous. That story didn't have nearly as good of an ending as I had hoped. It kind of just petered out. But yeah, so... You know, I'm hoping that my body will start healing itself eventually. That will probably require good shoes, though. Actually, that might even help with my back a little bit, too. 1-888-711-2007. 1-888-711-2007. Do I remember anything that happened in the year 2007? Not really. I don't know, like, some people just, like, have, like, this photographic memory. They'll be like, oh, yes, 2007, the year that this happened. I'm like... I couldn't even tell you what happened in 2015, really, except for I went to the thrift store a couple of times. Devin's up next, and he has his super stash going on. Devin Wainwright, the 3-star cosmetic dentist, and Leo looking for a woman. His interests include tinkering in the shed, Wellington boots, and archery. He loves brown eyes and blonde hair, active, methodical, introvert, traditional, and spicy. His bad habit is chewing nails, and his guilty pleasure is spending money. A practical type. Man, I love spending money. That's why I need so much of it. So I'm going to try Melody Overhauser first, the 2-star festival organizer, and Cancer. They have 3 ticks of attraction. That's pretty sweet. She likes studying ley lines. I don't really know what that means. Pet guinea pigs and gentle exercise. Maybe that's practical. I don't know. Why can't everyone I take just, have a 5 out of 5 match that I've already seen? You know, just get like 10 5 out of 5s in a row. That way I'll know that I'm doing something kind of right, I guess. Let's see. We are ready to order. What would you like? Something hot with no meat. I'm sure we can make that happen. Like pipirada. There we go. Let's get some omelets over here. Oh my gosh, I almost did the up in here joke. Almost. Whoa, that's been so long since I've done that. Talk or less and sit at the back or sit at the front. Of course you want to sit at the front. Yeah, you just, why would you ever want to do that? But then the professor will see you and will call on you and just, nothing good ever comes out of it. See, did I do anything else with my Saturday? Not really, I kind of just spent the day watching YouTube. Oh, wardrobe malfunction. Okay, so we have blonde pigtails with the swoodly-doos. Silver studs and then blue on white with the overalls. Okay, I can figure this out. What you got? Oh, you changed to gold hoops. Did you miss me? Lol. It wasn't that funny, okay? So yeah, I know you changed your earrings. It's really nice that you went and did that. I don't really know why, though. Don't you, like, meticulously choose out an outfit for a date? Like, why would you just be like, just like swoop in, just be like, they're not digging my silver studs like I thought they would, and then just like, we're gonna fix that. aerobics to a fitness video or slob on the sofa. Oh, 1 out of 3. Now I'm not digging these two together anymore. That's a shame. I was hoping that's gonna hit the one red space, isn't it? Wow, game. You're really gonna do that to me? Fine. When we were at the thrift store, I actually found another jersey that I almost ended up buying. This one I didn't, because when I looked on eBay for the prices, they were only like $14, so I'm like, there's really no money to be made there. But it was like a Jerry Garcia 49ers jersey. So it was pretty cool. There was also a Brett Favre Minnesota Vikings jersey. Or maybe it's not. I don't know if Brett Favre like has a sibling or something, but it was Favre on the Minnesota Vikings. I just don't remember Brett Favre ever playing for the Vikes. But I saw that, and I was like, ooh, this one might be good too, but it was like $16 at the thrift shop, and I was like, nah, that's a little too much. Although maybe that means it actually was a really good deal, and I should have done it. But, whatever. Live and learn. I don't need lots of jerseys just piling up in my closet before I get around to selling them. Speaking of, I should probably start working on the eBay listing or something. So I guess we'll move on to Thea Halfheard, the alternative music star, and an Aries. That's good, they actually line up there. 2 ticks of attraction for these two, not as much as the last ones, but maybe their personalities will be better. She likes playing the violin, DVD movie extras, and plane spotting. So let's go find out about her. I just realized something that while I was in that loading screen is I haven't gotten another update about how my avatar is doing in the dating world. I wonder if it waits for you to do like a certain amount of dates, and then just because there's not a really big player base of this game, it just takes forever. I just want something hot with red meat, like reindeer meatballs from our long, light brown-haired waiter person. So of course we need to shoot the VIP. Actually, my friend bought a shirt a lot like this one today. It's like a bright yellow, can't remember if it was a collared shirt. It wasn't a flannel like hers looks to be, but whatever. When it comes to work, do you never take days off or pull a sickie now? Can't get anything right on these dates, apparently. Hit this one green one, please, though. That would be super swell. Oh, or, you know, just swing by it. It's not like I want you to succeed in life or anything. No, of course not. I'm just here to, you know, set you up with the perfect person who you don't need to work for at all because they'll just immediately like you. Like, come on. Thank you for lying. Yes, take each day as it comes. Take each lie as it comes as well. And grab that 20 coins, so we're only 5 coins down from that lie. And still further behind than I'd like to be, so you better pay me back after this date. Would you rather go on a date to an afternoon tea room or a drag cabaret show? Okay, you guys are lining up a little bit. We are a real hot tamale and the indubitablies. Oh boy, Rocco. Oh, Rocco. This is... Oh, right. It's Thea. The wonderful Thea. Also known as Thea. It rhymes with T. I'm pretty sure. I've studied name pronunciation. I'm going to abort that joke. It's not even worth it. But they do both want to ask their mom when they're in a fight or whatever. I can't remember what the actual question is. But so that works out really well. That means they're 2 out of 3, which is definitely second date territory. So yes, let us call it a night and head out. They are rather... Did anything go wrong in that date? No. Do I want to? It's probably not worth it. I don't know what I'm thinking, because they were only 2 out of 3. They weren't 3 out of 3. And of course we need to continue hitting all of the hard restaurants just to keep Thea happy, because she's a VIP, which means she's very snooty about the places she eats. We have Black Flock Seagulls here, and you want something hot with white meat this time. Why would you ever want that? Peking Duck. Duck is white meat, right? Yeah. It is, because I know pork's not, and the other ones were fish or vegetarian. So now, we continue, so do we talk about bad habit? I guess we do. Bad habit of being paranoid? I actually rather like that. We have a bad habit of chewing nails. Oh, come on. What if you chew your nails when you're paranoid? Like... Come on, don't just like dismiss it like that. So that's gonna make things very difficult to set up. I guess we might as well do guilty pleasure then. If they had like both liked each other's, I probably wouldn't have done it. Oh, it's nothing to be ashamed of. See, but the problem is now that just because of that one strike, we probably can't hook up with her because she's a VIP and therefore does not appreciate these two are men. Thea's a woman. She would not appreciate our advances after having a strike on the date, unless we find a way to get rid of it. But I don't think we can. So we would want another date with her if we're going to have a chance at setting them up. So New Year's Eve, would you rather stay at home, read a book, or spend it with friends and family? But now I'm feeling like it's not even worth the time for that, because these two apparently just don't want to be together. They're trying everything in their power to just not line up well on this second date. Except for guilty pleasures. That one went all right. Bad habits. Oh no, don't roll over. Don't roll over. Don't roll. I know you're going to. Oh, but come on. Man, my brain is so slow today. I did not get very good sleep. I can tell that. So let's give them 8%. 315 would be 63. So... Yep, let's do that. 252. And we're going to head out of here. I don't even think we can ask her out or ask her on another date. I'm just going to say, you know, I think we should just be friends. And I was right. That is, in fact, what she was thinking. So, whew, dodge that bullet. Well, there are only 2 girls left in the Black Book who we don't know anything about, which means there's only 2 more chances of something better than like a 4 out of 5. So let's try Lillian Dickenthwaite. What a great last name. She's a 2-star eco warrior and an Aquarius born on January 24th. No real attraction, but that's not terrible with a 3 and 2 star. She does like reality TV though, and teeth whitening, so she might like the fact that he spends money. And we didn't get the restaurant we really wanted, and he's back to black hair. So, you know, we're just going around spending all the money and not getting the payout that we want for all of this, but his black hair is so current. And we just have Brown's, like, middle part here. And we want something hot with white meat with no tomatoes. I'm sure we can do that. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do the chook and veg pie, because I had to think. I was like, are tomatoes vegetables? Do I need to be worried? And then I realized, no. Tomatoes are a fruit. So you join in to earn alms for the needies, or wish give them a tenner? Of course, yeah. Give them a tenner. No, come on. You gotta go skydiving with them. It's a once-in-a-lifetime experience, and it's for charity, which means you're not even paying for it. Heck, if I got a free skydiving and got to feel good about it, even I might consider going. Oh my gosh, these two are terrible. Like, I'm deathly afraid of, like, heights, and actually not so much heights, so much as falling. I have no problems, like, being on a bridge, but if I, like, look over the side of the bridge, whoo, not a fun time to be in my mind right there. I'm just like, whoa, I get, like, really bad vertigo. I start, like, swaying back and forth, and I get really nervous and scared, so I'm just like, you know, let's just not do that, I suppose. But, you know, with an expert teacher strapped to my back, there's a chance I could be swayed to jump out of a plane. Maybe. I'd need other people to do it with me, though. Not just going at it alone when watching TV. Do you prefer to watch alone or watch with friends? Wow, you guys decided to line up on something. Yeah, you do not follow the herd, that is very certain. We get to tell the chef the easy thing about the food. It had an incredibly intoxicating texture. It was totally and completely satisfying. It had an undeniable underbelly of fragrant mistiness, had a pleasantly subtle overtone of wistful wondrousness, and it had a dreamy, inspired aftertaste. Yeah, simply thrilled to hear it. And it is time to shoot. Let's get out of here. I'm not really sure that this is gonna go over too well, though. Well, he's only undecided, so that's good. Yep, we can meet again. It's gonna be a maze, so let's get on out of here. I guess we'll finish off the Black Book with Catherine Oldlong, the two-star henna tattoo artist, and a Libra. No attraction. She likes oil painting, blue sky thinking, and modern dance. It looks like she's not wearing anything because these tabs are in front of her clothes. That's weird. And so let's just, maybe these two will be the surprising, stunning turn of events where they're actually a good couple. Oh, but I'm so tired of Swedish food. We have it all the time, says no one ever, except for maybe Swedish people, except then they just call it food. I don't know, I've like never had just straight up Swedish food, but we have long blonde hair and you want something hot with no meat. Okay, I can do this. Regmunk. Potato pancakes, yes. Let's get that. That's hot with no meat. I know how to do. I guess we'll start with social. Sounds like a good place because it gives it to us right there, and immediately we miss out on the possibility of a 5 out of 5. Maybe I can get the 30 coins though. That would be pretty sweet. Or no, you're just gonna overshoot and give me nothing. That is just mean. Why can't you just be nice to me, huh, game? Maybe give me the 15. Maybe you'll give me the 15. Okay, thank you, game. I'm starting to give you a little bit of leeway right now. Okay. 45 more minutes until puck drop for the Sharks versus Ducks game. Huge rivalry tonight. That's gonna be great. Obviously, I want the Sharks to win, if that wasn't clear. Oh my gosh, these two are terrible. But by the time you guys see this, well, the winner will already be determined. And let's see, the Sharks could either, you know, win and start building a streak. Or, actually, would it be starting to build a streak? Yeah, because we just beat Florida, so it'd only be two, but it'd be something. Or they could lose and go back to having their, like, 50-50 start. I think they would actually be about 7-7, maybe 7-6, or 6-6, or something like that. Or, the Ducks could win, and they could continue their streak that I believe they have. Okay, she's spicy. Or they could lose and continue having a bad start. So obviously I want the Ducks to have a bad start and the Sharks to be a good team. So it's pretty obvious what needs to be done. So I already know that they line up on spiciness. So we're at two, no, we're at one out of three. Oh, never mind. It's not even that good. But I mean, hey, two out of four. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Except it is broke, so please fix it. So 433, 866, plus 87, 866, Oh my gosh, why is this so hard? Okay, well, let's just do. I believe that's it, because it was the only one that was within the $9 range. And I was like, well, it's going to be like $9.40-something. I was a little off on my math, but thankfully it worked out in the end. Would you like to meet me again? Yeah, she had a terrific time. Probably not going to meet her again. I guess we need to continue going through the book to see if there's anyone who we might have a chance of 4 out of 5 with. So Evangeline Deeplo is the best match that we have that might be a 4 out of 5. She's a 2-star gastronaut and a Pisces, they don't line up there, but 2 ticks of attraction. She likes looking after sick people, grocery coupons, and hiking. I believe that definitely makes her practical and a little bit vintage. 2 out of 3, and you know, we just gotta hope that it turns into a 4 out of 5. Have at it, you two. Be amazing together and maybe make me amazing babies. I'm looking for 13 more if you want to be like the first like family to have like 13 babies in this game. That'd be pretty sweet. I'd be super happy. I would like rejoice and whatnot. You want something hot with no meat. I suppose we can do that. Risotto asparagi. Can't go wrong with that. Give me the coins. We're almost to 43,000. We're 99 coins away from that. That's pretty sweet. I mean, how many coins are we going to have by the end of this series? That's the real question. When you go out for the evening, do you go home at a certain time or play it by ear? Of course you play it by ear, because why would you do anything else? Can you just please work with me? Please give me a decent match for him. I'm not asking for very much. I'm not even asking for a 5 out of 5 anymore. But for a person who doesn't seem to just like spit in the face of everything he stands for, oh, of course I'd play it by the nose, ear. Yeah, that one. Play it by ear. And she's like, nah, that ain't gonna fly. I know you're lying. Okay, so I did see an orange and purple down there, but it is orange, so we can just do that. Wear a nice apron or do it in your undies. Oh, I didn't mean to do that, but, you know, I messed it up anyways, so these two are absolutely terrible together also. Okay, let's get her back. Let's get her back. She had the blue eyes and the bun, and oh yeah, she's a girl, unlike those two. Like, come on, game. At least make this challenging for me. Yeah, cheers for finding you. I try not to leave people in the dark for too long. Okay, so talk about social then. Friends, hang out with one at a time. I don't think that's even going to come close to saving the date, but we're gonna try and go halvesies. I forgot that we're not on a hard restaurant, so it didn't move nearly as fast as I thought. So I'm not positioning my coins very well for what I want. That's fine. We'll be okay. Oh my gosh, they're all falling on her side. Oh, except this one guy is gonna ruin it. Just watch. Oh, ooh. Oh, Evangeline pays the bill. You know, she got us covered. We got this, and they do want to close the restaurant. However, will he want another day? Actually, you know what? He's fine with it. So, please? Not getting any younger. Let's have another date then, okay? Let's not. I'm honestly at a loss of what to do, so I guess we'll try Edith Bowling. She's new, even though they look like a terrible match. She's a 1-star milk delivery person and a Cancer. No attraction. She seems very nerdy and edgy. Mostly edgy. I don't know what to do. At this point, this episode's just going to drag on forever. Because he's not even rejecting anyone. So Edith, Devin, yes. Honestly, at this point, I'm just willing to set him up with anyone. So if this doesn't work out, he's just going to get a 3 out of 5. Or, you know, whatever I can muster for him. Because, come on, dude, for real? What would you like? Something cold with no meat. Inari sushi, there we go. Yep, tofu sushi, I got this. As opposed to maki sushi. Yeah, see? I'm learning, I'm relearning these. You have to decorate a room. Do you do it yourself or organize a painting? You know what? She may be 1-star, but I'm not going to tell her the truth just because that will just sadden everyone at the table. He's still going to fail at lying. Like, I'm actually mad. Actually, hold on. Nope. Sorry I got mad at you. Yeah, he did it. We'll see if I can set these two up, but the lying should be pretty easy. I just wish I didn't need to lie because I want them to actually have things that they agree on. So flat pack furniture, read the instructions, or make it up. Okay, we're reading the instructions. We are the organized pair, and that is an errant arachnid, but no longer. We have destroyed it. It will not be bothering you any longer, girl whose name I have totally not forgotten. Okay, so get stuck in or only clean for guests? Oh, of course you only clean for guests. Why would I expect anything different from you? At least this lie is gonna go off without a hitch. Ay, 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 what do I do? What do I do? It is nice to just relax. Yes, let's get the bill. I don't remember who our waiter was. I think it was Bethany. Yeah, because I feel like I would have remembered Dolly more, but thank you. Thank you, Bethany, and we are going to call it a night. Let's get out of here, but he's going to be like, I'm undecided, frankly. Oh, well, hey, you want to be my one and only? There we go. How romantically fortuitous. These two were going to break up. I'm calling it now. And I don't even get to see how our first match ends up. They were 5 out of 5, and I kind of want to know. I think they'll be middling. I'm going to say engaged for them. The next two are going to have a very, very messy breakup. It will absolutely be brutal. But yeah, I don't think we're going to get any babies off of either of those matches. But you know, they were 5 out of 5 the first ones, so there's always a small chance. I'm supposed to remind you to like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Until next time on Kitty Powers Matchmaker, our quest for all the achievements, goodbye.